good afternoon. OK, so 亲爱的 Form Tree， 现在外面在下雨，一直打雷。如果你有听到下雨的声音很吵，或者是打雷的声音很吵，你不要听，你听我讲话，你听我讲话就可以了。OK， so our new title, new chapter actually, 新的 chapter.Reactivity series of matter. In Chinese, we call 金属的活跃度。Okay, so what's mean by reactivity series of matter? 什么叫金属的活跃度呢？ Okay, so look at your note, your cover, 你的封面。Make sure you bring your notes 啊，自己印啊，这一次。Okay, so now what to do? 要怎么做呢？ Okay, look at your notes.Copy somewhere around here， 在这边抄一些东西啊。So what is mean by reactivity series of matter？ 什么叫金属的活跃度呢 ？Copy here. You may be not having the box， 你可能没有这个格子啊，不要理它啦，抄下去就可以了。Okay， so reactivity series of matter， 金属的活跃度什么意思呢？来 ，copy first， 先抄。A series of matters， 一个系列的金属。For me, this is a table， 它是一个表格来的。We saw the reactivity of matter when react with other minerals. So this table show you the matters. This table having a lot of matter， 它里面有很多金属。And the table tell you how reactive is the matter， 那个金属的活跃度高或者是低。什么叫活跃不活跃呢？活跃就是喜欢起化学反应呢。They like to having the chemical reaction, okay, with other minerals. So a table or a series of matter, we saw the reactivity of matter when react with other minerals like oxygen, water, acid, and alkaline. Or simply 简单的话，简单的说就是金属的活跃度，就是那个金属到底它活跃不活跃。活跃不活跃不是因为它会拉二胡，它会打琵琶，不是。OK， 活跃不活跃就是因为它能起化学反应吗？它起化学反应的时候快吗？这种就叫金属的活跃度。OK， so now an example， 有什么 example 呢？ OK， so now separate your table into three parts， 把你的表格分成三大部分。One， two， three。 So draw two line， 画两条线先。等你一下。 OK， and now for the carbon and hydrogen， carbon and hydrogen you write here， 写在这边。 Non-matter， non-matter， 非金属，非金属。 This table called the reactivity series of matter， 金属的活跃度。 But actually in the table we having two non-matter， 里面有两个非金属。OK， 嘎嘎焦焦的非金属 carbon and hydrogen they are inside， so please mention 强调一下 non-matter non-matter 非金属来的。 OK， and now why I ask you to separate them into three group or three part， 为什么把表格呢分成三大部分呢？ Simple， so the, for the first part， 第一个部分 the lowest part they are the matter， 它们都是金属， but they are the non-reactive matter， 不活跃的金属。Okay, second part, reactive, 比较活跃的金属。 And the highest, 最高的那一个 part, they are very reactive matter, 非常活跃的金属。 Very reactive matter, 非常活跃的金属。 So, 不活跃，活跃，非常活跃。 Okay, oh, what's the meaning of this arrow? 这个箭头是什么意思呢？The higher the position of the matter in this table， 如果金属的位置在这个表格的位置更高的话，它就是比较活跃了。So when the arrow， so what's mean by the arrow？ 这个箭头代表着什么意思呢 ？The reactivity of matter towards oxygen and other mineral increase， 金属跟其他的化学物品、跟其他的矿物质，它们的活跃度增加。Another meaning， 也就是说它比较厉害起化学反应。比较活跃的意思啦， so copy 慢慢抄一下。 OK， any example 有什么例子呢？ No need to purposely remember， 不用特意去背的。 After you finish the chapter 4 you automatically almost can remember， 几乎能明白。你一明白过后你直接会背了，直接有它的背出了，不用背也直接会记得，好奇怪啊。 OK， so an example， non-reactive matter 不活跃的金属 and the least reactive matter 最不活跃的金属呢 actually we call it as gold 进来的 and this is a symbol 它的标志就是这个 gold copy ok followed by silver 银 and this is mercury 水银来的They are non-reactive matter 它们都是不活跃的金属、What's mean by non-reactive? 什么叫不活跃呢 Okay, They never combine together They never having the chemical reaction with others 永远不会跟其他的化学起化学物品起化学反应 Or another meaning They never join together with others mineral To become compound 永远不会变成化合物它永远都是地球里面的元素没有掺到别的东西 They are pure 它们都是纯正的物质来的 So non-reactive matter 不活跃的金属 Exist in the form of element in the nature 在我们的大自然呢它们用元素的形态出现什么叫元素就是一种东西里面只有一种原子没有掺到其他的原子我们就叫它元素 OK So non-reactive They areElement in the nature 在我们的大自然它们都是元素来的 But maybe you not understand 其实可能不明白对不对 OK We look at example gold 我们来看金一下 OK So gold is non-reactive 金一点都不活跃 So in the nature Gold never combine together with others To become the compound Become the new compound 变成新的化合物 So gold never combine together with the carbon Become black gold 不会有这种事情发生 OrWhen you found the gold in the nature, 当你在大自然找到金啊，那一块金就是纯金，明白吗？什么都不用做，收在 pocket 里面不要喊 ，OK? You get a pure gold, 你就拿到你最想要得到的东西 ，gold 纯金 ，OK? So 金不用去找，不用去做了，你在地上找到的时候，它就是这样子罢了。里面只有一种东西，金不会跟别人化合变成新的化合物。Okay, gold 进来的 If I having the gold that's so big like this I don't teach tuition anymore 我就不教补习了啦 Okay, so all these they are gold 这是就是你在大自然找到的金它亮晶晶什么都不用做直接收起来就可以卖了的这种就叫 gold 纯正的元素因为它不活跃不会跟别人化合它们就叫元素 Okay, 这种就是不活跃的金属 And now we continue for othersSo after the mercury, 水银过后呢它们就比较活跃了 Followed by copper, 铜 Lead, 铅铅笔芯的铅 Tin, 细矿的细米啊细米 Iron, 铁 Okay, they have become more reactive, 它越来越活跃了 Hydrogen, okay, hydrogen But remember, hydrogen is a non-metal lah.Hydrogen 是非金属来的、虽然它的名字在这个表格里面出现还有谁呢金 OK Carbon And Aluminium And they are reactive matter 它们都是活跃的金属叫 reactive matter、So what's mean by reactive 什么叫做活跃呢 OK I use example maybe Iron 铁啊So if you study geography, they tell you, in Pahang, 在彭亨州 it contains a lot of iron, 有很多很多的铁。So now you buy a bus ticket, you go to Pahang, and you're searching for iron, 你要找铁对不对 But where's the iron? 铁在哪里呢 Okay, the iron bar, 它是一条条的铁枝在埋在地底下等你去找吗、你做梦啊哈做梦 okay?So where's the iron in Pahang? 在彭亨州铁在哪里呢不知道 Okay, so I show you lah What happened to the iron in the nature? Iron is because of reactive 铁是活跃的 So in the nature, it combined together with oxygen Maybe become the new mineral called iron oxide 它可能就变成了一种新的矿物质就叫氧化铁、How is the iron oxide? 那这整座山呢都叫氧化铁 Iron oxide Okay, for you, maybe you call this as what? 石头你叫它昂陶红土对不对 But they are iron oxide Or let's say your geography teacher tell you Pahang having a lot of irons When you go searching for irons And you get nothing 什么都找不到你就很生气你拿着一块石头对不对 And 你在彭亨州一直喊老师你给我小心我回家我一定拿石头丢你的车 其实这粒石头就是铁来的 ，iron oxide 氧化铁。OK， 还有什么的 example 呢 ？OK， 再来看 aluminium geohol having a lot of aluminium. I still remember 我在 form 3读 geography 的时候记得到现在。OK， aluminium 因为曾经想过要去 geohol 找 aluminium。OK， so how is aluminium in geohol？ 在 geohol 的 aluminium 到底是这样子的，怎样的呢？那这个叫 aluminium 呢 ？aluminium。它是不是一块一块的 aluminium 等你去拿 ？Sorry, so aluminium because of reactive, 因为它活跃啊 ，in the nature 在大自然的时候，它跟别的东西呢化合，它就变成了 aluminium oxide 氧化铝。那 now having aluminium oxide, you call it as what? 你叫它沙，你叫它小石头，对不对 ？You totally don't know, 你完全不知道它是 aluminium 来的。这种就是我们活跃的金属 In the nature 在大自然 They combine together with others to become new mineral 变成新的化合物 OK And now Last group 最后一组 Very reactive matter 非常活跃的金属谁来的呢 Magnesium 镁 Magnesium 金字旁一个镁美丽的镁 OK Calcium 钙 SodiumSodium, 它叫 OK in Chinese sodium, potassium. I don't know how to read 了，哈，我不会读 potassium. OK, magnesium, calcium, sodium, potassium. So what's mean by very reactive? 什么叫非常活跃呢 ？I using the example magnesium. 我用于 magnesium. OK. So in the firecracker, 在红炮。红炮有玩过吗？有拿过红炮，一粒红炮，然后点火给他们，砰，手断，对不对 ？So if you having the fine cracker, in the fine cracker, it contains a powder called magnesium. 里面掺了一种粉呢，叫 magnesium, very reactive matter, 非常活跃的金属。So now you give some fire, 你给它，你点香，然后你点它 magnesium. So when you put the fire closer, what happened? Magnesium very reactive, 它非常活跃。So when you supply some heat energy, it react with oxygen in the air. 它在空气中呢跟氧气化合，就变成了氧化镁。So 这种就叫活跃的金属了，就是很容易起化学反应会爆炸。Or potassium sodium, you can use it to make bomb, 可以用来做 bomb 的。OK, so 这种就叫活跃的金属。Or for very reactive matter, 这种非常活跃的金属 ，in our classroom or in our lab 啊，在科学室里面 ，we keep them under the oil. 我们把它收在油的下面 ，paraffin oil, 蜡油、煤油的下面。OK， 那 sodium, potassium, lithium, 它们都放在油的下面。Why? To prevent they react together with oxygen, 防止它们跟氧气化合爆炸。OK。So this is what we call very reactive, 非常活跃。And now, what is mean by reactive matter? 什么叫活跃的金属呢 ？Okay, copy first. 来 ，react with others mineral to form compound in nature. Because they are reactive, they react with others mineral to form compound in the nature. 因为它活跃，在大自然跟别人化合，变成的化合物。Or for you, you call stone 石头了。你们叫它矿物质石头 ，OK？ Or they react together with what？ 它跟谁化合在一起呢？跟哪一种东西化合在一起呢 ？Number one, maybe they can join together with oxygen. 它跟氧气化合，变成氧化物。So reactive matter react together with oxygen, become metal oxide， 就变成了氧化物。Or maybe the metals react together with the carbon, oxygen, 跟碳跟氧呢化合在一起，变成碳化物 ，metal carbonate. Metal carbonate mean metal carbon they combine chemically lah, and oxygen they become metal carbonate. Or reactive matter maybe joined together with the sulfur, 可能跟硫磺呢化合在一起 ，and become metal sulfide 硫化物。Oh, they are all mineral. 这就是我们所谓的矿物质 ，OK. 然后比较 cheap 的讲法就是九桃石头 ，OK. 山上的石头，地下的石头，你家前面的石头。Or reactive matter react together with the silica, react together with oxygen to become metal silicate 就变成另外一种矿物质，就叫 metal silicate. Okay, so this is what we call reactive and non-reactive 活液跟不活液，也就是会起化学反应或者不会起化学反应了。 You can look at example again. Sodium react together with the water. 你把 sodium 丢进水里面，它一动到水啊，马上起化学反应，没有爆炸。Okay, or potassium, if you throw it into the water, 了，就是这样子快了。Okay, so setter. Continue the next title. Okay, bye bye.